Hi and welcome to this little series of tutorials on how I'm doing my pixel art. Today we're having a little digital Bob Ross moment. We're going to paint a landscape, a dark forest at night in the moonlight. I'm using DPaint.js, which is an image editor I'm building myself. DPaint.js is mainly targeted towards old retro machines of the 80s, like the Commodore Amiga and the Atari. But it has some cool modern features that I wanted to demonstrate. Now the end result will be 16 colors on a small drawing area of 320 at 265 pixels. But that doesn't mean we have to push every pixel in place by hand. We can start in full 24-bit mode with all the paint tools we want and worry about the color reduction later. Okay, Bob Ross time. Let's start with our base layer. You can have two drawing colors at any time. A foreground color and a background color. Left-click drawing paints the foreground color, black in this case, and right-click drawing paints the background color, white. Let's pick some blue and teal to get started. The goal is to have a rough backdrop for our forest. We'll add detail later, for now we want broad strokes and a first impression of the light and dark areas. Changing the transparency to give a more layered appearance. By the way, the complete image took me several hours to create, which would make a very boring video, so I have sped up the painting parts. Okay, that will do for now. We'll spice it up with several effects. I'm duplicating the layer each time and let's bring in our alchemy magic. Alchemy are scripts you can tweak yourselves to provide all sorts of interesting effects. The dabble one, for example, takes a random spot in the image and starts dabbling a bit with the color it finds there. Another one, speckles. This one plots light and dark spots with a whole range of options. And another one, frost. Gives a web-like structure to the image. Okay, one last one more. Some more speckles. Okay, now a trick I use all the time, the layer mask. Think of a layer mask as some sort of see-through layer on top of the image that you can scratch away or fill back up to only show the parts of the layer you want. When you paint with white on the layer mask, you reveal the layer. When you paint with black, you conceal it again. This command, add layer mask height, adds a layer mask and makes it all black, so the entire layer is hidden. Click on the little mask icon to make it active, and then your paint actions will be on the mask instead of on the layer. Now, if you paint with a large soft white brush, you can blend in just the parts of the layer you want. Adding some smudge here to have an impression of some northern light flares. Oops, it seems my mask isn't active. No, doesn't matter, we can just blend in some other layers. Okay, that's about it. Combining all these layers gives us a nice texture to work with. Applying all layer masks. This kind of bakes the transparency mask into the layer. We don't need all these layers anymore, so let's flatten the image, squashing all layers into one. That's our background. Okay, time for some trees. To get a nice tree texture, we're not going to paint them directly with a dark color. Nope, we're going to use our layer mask trick again. First, we generate a nice texture. Something like that. And add the mask. Now if you paint with the left mouse button, white color, we reveal the layer. If you paint with the right mouse button, we conceal the layer. And if we use some transparency in our paintbrush as well, we have a really nice system of painting with a structure. By constantly switching the left and right mouse button, we can draw and erase in the same movement. and our soft transparent brush makes it come alive. Drawing over the same spot again makes the paint or erase effect bigger, and drawing only once leaves a bit of transparency. It's subtle because we're working with such a dark layer, but it makes a huge difference in texture and richness of the image. Some branches, another tree. The top corners should be really dark. Of course, Bob Ross would just splash on some paint on the canvas and it would look exactly like a tree. But yeah, I'm not at Bob level yet. Make our brush smaller for the smaller trees. A more transparent brush gives a softer stroke. Some forest terrain. I think it's a bit snowy. Okay, time for some branches. We're going to use a different texture layer, one that gives on its own the impression of light branches. Add the layer mask again. And if we combine that texture with some transparent branch drawing, it gives us quite a convincing texture. Another texture, heavier branches now. And again, some angled branches hanging down. Conceal and slowly reveal again. This double texture whammy in the same stroke is really one of my favorite tricks, and also one of the main reasons to create my own software. I mean, of course, Photoshop and others can do more or less the same, but that doesn't have the right left-click drawing. So relaxing. Okay, I think our dark layer is about done. Some quick shading corrections. Add some sharpness. Let's leave it like that. Next, of course it's not only dark, we have some light as well. After all, it's snowy. New layer, fill it with white, and paint over reveal our highlights. Some color corrections, let's make it a more cool moonlight vibe. The dark parts seem a bit dead. Let's make that come alive again. Better. Some additional sharpness to make the details stand out. And we could use some more trees in the far distance. Now, for the final touch, some stars. There, I think we're done. Now, I deliberately stayed within a monochrome blue-green palette, so normally, when we reduce the color count to 16, it still should be somewhat okay. Well, we'll lose some of the richness, of course, but let's see. Okay, the automatic conversion is not too bad. As always, some handmade pixel pushing is needed, but let's not overdo it. After all, it is a deserted forest. it's okay if it's a little rough. You see, these dark areas are a bit of a pain. Adding some light. We have these super handy dither options in the brush, so you don't have to push every pixel yourself in a dither pattern. Done! Except for the most important part, our signature. Now preview it on our retro system. Ooh, that's dark. Let's swap the colors. And there it is, our Midnight Forest in low-res 16 color mode on Amiga. Thanks for watching.